Good evening, and thank you so much for joining the St. Albans Museum tonight. We're going to have the Rail City Raffle. I'm your host, Interim Executive Director Lisa Evans, but tonight's real star is the conductor for the evening, best known as Railroad Guy, Jim Murphy. Tonight, you can get ready for an exciting evening of drawings and prizes and some historic clips from some of Jim's personal DVD collections. You can see that first clip now.
People, they don't want to look at the camera, but yet they want to have their picture taken. They'll do everything to get their picture taken. World of Mirth, fair is on or coming up, in essence. I don't show the year on the poster. They all look suspicious of what they're doing with that camera. What's he pointing at me? What the? Whoop. Gotta look where you're going.
Welcome back. All right, the first drawing of the evening is for a Civil War collector's package.
Are you ready, Lisa?
We're ready, Conductor Jim.
Okay, here we go. Ready. This is for drawing number one. And the number is number 89. That's 89.
Winner number 89. All right, get ready for the next drawing, number two, right after this next clip.
Good morning. A beautiful day to ride a steam train. Let's follow the various people connected with the train through their daily routine to ready the train for its southbound trip to Rutland. From New Hampshire must keep that firebox clean. A bad fire could mean burnt grate and a dead engine. Comes from a fire plug. The conductor and trainmen are in charge of this operation. A small amount of oil here and there assures a smooth run, hopefully. They must watch that hose on top of the tender. If it gets loose, it could hit somebody.
All right, that was great. Get ready for drawing number two. The winner is going to receive a painting print of downtown St. Albans by local St. Albans artist Sean Dye.
All aboard for number two. And we have number 100.
Winner number 100. Fantastic. Get ready to collect that prize. We're going to have drawing number three right after this next clip. That was great. I love that clip. All right, before we go on to the next drawing, I just want to thank some of our sponsors, those sponsors who gave to the Rail City Raffle as our level one givers, Local Med Associates, Inc., and Local St. Albans Hannaford, as well as the Local Unique Kitchen Store as the crow flies. Thank you so much for sponsoring. All right, get ready for the next drawing right after this.
This looks to be the Montrealer, number 21, arriving St. Albans. Usually came into St. Albans almost in the dark, 6:30 or so. Today must have been running really late. The man that was standing in the green clothes, I think, was more King of St. Albans. He was a porter. Engineer puts his valise up on the engine. Fireman comes off after watering the engines, and the overhead is for the steam pipes that ran between the engine house and all the buildings where steam was supplied for heating. Leaving St. Albans, all the buildings in the background, of course, the blacksmith shop, all shops are gone. In 1991, now all we have is a shopping center over there. Seems to be leaving town.
No. Fantastic. All right, get ready for our third prize drawing. The winner of this one is going to win a vintage St. Albans t-shirt created by the St. Albans Museum, as well as a signed copy by the authors of the Local Images of America St. Albans book.
You're ready, Lisa. According to my railroad Waltham watch here, I think we're on ready to take number three. So we'll go to number three.
Fantastic.
And this is number 95.
Winner number 95. Fantastic. Let's go to the next one, Jim, right after this next clip.
Sorry with this one. An airplane. This is down on the big field by the corner of the Kellogg Road and the Lake Road. They used that field as an airport for many years. And this airplane was built, I'm told, by a man from Milton, Vermont, German ancestry, who built his own planes and flew them. And this is one of his flights out of the field down there by the Gay Farm, I should say. Kellogg Road runs along up by that farm on the hill. The Lake Road would be behind us. At first when I saw that, I thought Batman had arrived with his bat plane. Beautiful flight, though. This field was used by Amelia Earhart in the early 1930s to land her own airplane here when she came up for meetings at the railroad. This gentleman could fly his plane wonderfully, too. But sometime.
I'm really excited to thank tonight's level two sponsors of the Rail City Raffle. First up, we have Handy Buick GMC Cadillac, a family-run business since 1958, whose commitment to a positive sales experience has made them one of the top GMC dealers in Vermont. I also want to thank Heald Funeral Home. As a local family-owned business since 1918, Heald's is located in the third oldest house in St. Albans. They're a warm and beautiful setting which offers warm and beautiful services for your loved ones. I also want to thank The Eloquent Page, a traditional brick-and-mortar bookstore located in historic downtown St. Albans, where there's new and used, classic and modern, vintage and exciting. You can find whatever your creative soul desires at The Eloquent Page. We also want to thank the Village Frame Shop and Gallery for sponsoring us. Along with gorgeous art and an array of gifts, the Village Frame Shop is the perfect place for all of your professional framing, reproduction, and printing needs. We also want to thank Local Diso Realty by Brendan Diso, whose favorite aspect of real estate is working to make the goals and dreams of his clients happen. He's attentive, knowledgeable, and will go above and beyond to help you buy or sell, or both, residential and commercial properties. We also want to thank Rail City Market, your friendly neighborhood market featuring local gifts and specialty foods, offering bulk teas, spices, nuts, maple syrup, honey, coffee, gluten-free, and more. And finally, but not least, is Handy Toyota, whose dynamic team is dedicated to earning your business again and again. Thank you so much for all of those Level 2 sponsors for the Rail City Raffle tonight, and we hope to have you back again for the third annual raffle next year. Jim, why don't we go ahead and do another drawing after this next clip?
It must be ice harvesting time. All these men stand around cutting the ice, pulling the ice out. Watch in the background. There's the old Bay store, which at one time was Younger's, I think it was called. See the ice? They're going to pull the ice out. They made a nice channel there. Man with his camera. Everybody carried cameras back then. What are they taking out of the ice? Well, this film, I was told, was taken somewhere in 1927 or 1928. After the bridge at Black Bridge was washed out in the 1927 flood. I couldn't believe it, but I was told this by the gentleman who knows about the story. Over at the farm, which is the Point Farm, they could not come across the bridge, so they drove their vehicles across the ice to bring the milk to market. And this truck went through the ice with the milk cans in the back, with Bob Brown and the hired hand in the truck. Bob said he went right to the bottom and came up awful fast. Was it cold? They got him back to the farm. He said it took him days before he thawed out. But there's a vehicle coming out of the ice at St. Albans Bay. The building in the background was the old dance pavilion. Truck is out, everything is safe. And that.
Great, let's go ahead and get ready for the next drawing. This winner is going to receive a gift certificate for a canvas print from the UPS store, along with a St. Albans Museum postcard package.
Well, Lisa, let's go for number four. And the number is 99.
Winner number 99. Fantastic. All right, I'm excited to see who the next winner is, Jim, right after this next clip. All right, we're getting halfway there, folks. Let's go ahead and draw our next winner, who's going to receive a Vermont Grow Shop $50 gift certificate.
Okay, here we go. I don't have a number in the bucket. Number 54.
Number 54 is our big winner. Fantastic. All right, I don't have to tell you, we're going to do our next drawing right after this next exciting clip.
Hurry up with those pennies, kids. That train is fast approaching. ought to use those again.
Okay, that was an exciting clip. Let's go ahead and do our next drawing. The winner is going to receive a train lover's package with a one-night stay at Hampton Inn.
Wow. Okay, here we go. Everybody ready? And this number is number 105. 105.
Winner 105. Let's go ahead and do another drawing right after another glimpse into railroad history.
In the St. Albans. 6218. See all the flanger cars, the plow cars, the work equipment sitting in the middle yard, the old scale track. Everything is gone. All you've got through there now is just the main track. And then the freight main beside that. The archway track around behind is still there. Same switch, same space.
All right, we're almost down to our top three prizes. Let's go ahead and pick number four. The winner is going to receive a gift certificate for $100 to Guy's Farm and Yard.
Oh, wrong side of my watch. Sorry. Yeah, I think we're ready, Lisa, right?
We're ready, Jim.
We're ready to go. And this is number 122. 122.
Winner 122. Congratulations for that gift certificate. Let's go ahead and take one more glimpse into railroad history before we get to those top cash prizes.
The next film are by Jim Murphy. St. Albans, Vermont. Ex-telegraph operator. Station agent. Dispatcher. Worked 1955 to 1968. Left in 68, came back in 80. This is in St. Albans, Winston Paquette, working in the yard as brakeman, 8027, one of the switchers sitting there. These are black and white, do not adjust your set. Dag Rushville, checker sealer in the yard. These films were processed by Jim Murphy at his own home. Looks like the fireman off the switcher, but unsure who this person is. 8093 backing in the yard. During the daytime, you may have found three switchers working, two in the yard and one at Beartown. This is the CTC board used to control the switches in the yard, put in 1956. This is the telegraph office area at Italy Yard. Lester, Coot Shepherd as we know him, clerk in the yard. Don Cross, listed St. Albans Bay, as a clerk. Another CV engine, 507, and the 700 class. Again in black and white. Jim Murphy, handing on train orders to 307 at Montpierre Junction. This is 429, northbound through Swanton, heading toward Brockville.
We'd like to take this break to thank our Level 4 sponsor, who's Harrison Concrete. a family-owned business on its third generation of concrete professionals that since 1968 has dedicated their lives to providing the very best concrete construction service, and more recently, the highest quality ready-mix product and service that's available in our area. Thank you so much, Harrison Concrete. We really thank you for your sponsorship. All right, I think we're ready to do those next top cash prizes right after another glimpse into railroad history.
This is a Way Freight from White River, arriving St. Albans past the train shed. Number 211. I believe the conductor was Olson Bludel. Look at the cars. That dates it. Train shed was torn down about September 29th, 1963. This is 332. Southbound Ambassador arriving St. Albans. The last ambassador to arrive in the station train shed before being torn down. And a long shot from south of St. Albans back towards the station. That's the farmer's siding south of St. Albans. Early next morning, the Montrealer arriving St. Albans through the train shed for the last time. Last train to arrive the train shed. 303 that day did not come into the train shed. A long shot from the north end of the train shed. And leaving St. Albans for the last time through the train shed. Frost on the ground. Camera frosted up a little bit. Authentic steam. Not put in there for looks. That was steam heated cars then. The man on the rear platform, Al Sharon, gives us a wave. And then later that day, the train shed comes down. Came down hard. They pulled and yanked and said it was unsafe, but it took them a couple hours before they got it to move. Didn't come down that.
All right. Thank you so much again to our sponsors. St. Albans Museum really looks forward to opening again this year. It is our 50th anniversary. The museum opened in 1971, and we hope to welcome all of you back to the museum this year. We have a lot of great programs and events, such as the Rail City Raffle. One of our most favorite events is the Lake Lessons, which is every September. And why don't you go ahead and take a look at that now.
We're here today for Lake Lessons, which is all about getting local students from the area schools down here to the lake and to understand how their watershed and how the lake connects to their lives and how they impact the lake.
The idea is that when we talk about St. Albans Bay or we talk about Lake Champlain, there's an environmental story and there's a historical story, and those aren't mutually exclusive. And so we wanted to find a way at the museum to be able to bring this to life for students in a way that would be meaningful for them. So for us, it was important that Lake Lessons would be place-based. So of course, we're down here at St. Albans Bay, and that it would be hands-on. So we reached out to a couple other community partners, state agencies, nonprofits, and educators to kind of bring together this series of workshops where we offer these half-day enrichment programs for free for local schools.
We're learning about what's getting put into our Lake Champlain and how we can fix what's going on.
Like basically how our everyday activities like affect and like create pollution.
Our station specifically is talking about agriculture and how farmers impact the lake through their practices and how they can protect water quality through conservation practices and best management practices.
I learned that like we can like build these little like troughs to like prevent like soil and like the stuff that's in soil from like going into the rivers, which flood into the lakes, which can make algae grow.
Like for cows, fences, you can put up fences and soil and all that stuff.
To me, that was so meaningful to be able to provide this opportunity where they could kind of interact with the natural world around them, learn about issues that impact the health of their ecosystem and what their role is and how they can play a part. And to me, that's, you know, what good science and good history education is all about.
I mean, it's cold. That's the only bad thing.
It's better than being in the classroom.
True. It's the truth.
Welcome back. We really are getting to the cash prize drawings now, and I'm so excited. All right, $250 for our third prize winner. Jim, give them a real good mix this time.
Yeah, sure. You want to do it? Number 19, 19.
Number 19, congratulations. You just won $250.
Wow.
All right, let's get to our second grand prize winner right after this.
The train shed that was going to fall down all by itself if they didn't tear it down, deemed it was unsafe. But all the ripping and tearing and everything they tried to do, nothing seemed to tear it down, except pure brute force. The beams had to be cut with chainsaws to make them fall. They wouldn't just fall by themselves. They were so solid. Built in 1867, torn down and started being torn down in September of 63, and these movies were taken in October of 63, looking south along the west wall towards Lake Street. The main part of the general office building, where your front door goes in from the track side now, into the hallway. Looking along the restaurant area, ticket office, baggage room, express room. That's what all these little rooms were used for. Well, they're going to tear down the north end. They put a cable through the window in the center and around the bottom of the portal and yanked and yanked and yanked, figuring that would take out the center support and that the building would collapse. But after cutting all the way through there and breaking all the bricks out, the building wall continued to stand. Well, it must be the side support on the west side that was still holding it up. Well, that's gone. It didn't go. Let's take off the end support. That will make it fall to the west, away from the building. And that didn't work. Well, let's take out the next one. Of course, eventually gravity does take its place and everything falls down. You have nothing holding it up. It's got to fall down. But that shows how not unsafe the building was. Looking towards the last building remaining now, which is now used by Amtrak. Looks like they were probably lucky that they didn't take off the front of the building there also. Because when it fell in that general direction. One last wall to take down on this side. And some more. You keep pulling it off, take out all the support, it's got to fall down. The rest of the building wasn't torn down until later on along the tracks. That was torn down somewhere between, probably 75 or 76. That's 1975 or 76. It was falling apart by then itself.
All right, we have so many exciting programs like Lake Lessons, and we really hope to invite you back. But for now, why don't we go ahead and get to the second cash prize drawing?
Are you ready?
I'm ready, Jim. Mix them up.
All aboard. This is number 98. 98.
Number 98, you just won $500.
Whoa,
fantastic. Congratulations. Great. All right, guys, we're going to get to that $1,000 cash prize drawing in just a second. But first, I want to show you a little something that we've been working on since 2019. Our Central Vermont Railway Railroad Exhibit Room. We've been renovating since then through the pandemic, and we're finally putting on the final touches.
Yes, make sure you come here. I've been a member here since for 44 years. I've spent my lifetime in here, partly to do with the railroad. Come and see the new room. You're going to be fantastic people to come up here and look at it. It's going to be greater. Come and see it, please.
And we're going to give you a sneak peek of it right now. Grand prize drawing, $1,000. All right, folks, get those tickets in hand. Hope your number is drawn.
Here it comes. We're looking for that number for $1,000. Number 101.
101, you just won $1,000. Congratulations.
Hey, everybody, there it is, Lisa. You hold that one there.
Oh, 101. I wish that was my number. It's not. Congratulations, 101. We're so happy for you. To all of our winners, congratulations. You can expect to hear from the museum next week to make arrangements to receive those prizes. For the others, better luck next year. But to everyone, thank you so much for supporting the St. Albans Museum for this year's Rail City Raffle. We hope to see you next year. Have a great night.
You too, Lisa.
Thanks, Jim.
Good night.